Hello everyone, welcome back to the study of economics. In the last episode, we have learned that some basic terms of collection of data. They are variables, statistical investigations, enumerators, good sample. All these things we discussed in the last episode. Today, in this session, we are going to deal with new concept, that is sources of data. What are the sources of data for collection of data? So this we can see here. Statistical data can be obtained from mainly two sources. They are primary data and secondary data. So these are the two sources of statistics. So primary data and secondary data. Now let me see what is primary data. Primary data means first hand information collected by an investigator. So it is first hand information collected by an investigator, and it is collected for the first time. It is not collected already. It is original in nature and more reliable. Thus, it is a type of data that is collected by researchers directly from main sources through interviews, surveys, experiments, etc. For example, market research, student thesis, census of population in India. So these are the best example for primary data. So remember, primary data is nothing but collection of data at first time. So this data are fresh. That means we are collected for first time. So this is what primary data. Then let me see, what are the merits of primary data? First one, it has high degree of accuracy. Why the primary data having high degree of accuracy? Because here we are collecting the data directly for the first time. Thus, here the informations are to be true. Because we are collect the informations directly by the population, by the people. Thus, it should have high degree of accuracy. Second one, for some inquiries, secondary data is not available. That means, for the collection of information, we need first hand information, because we cannot get secondary data or we cannot get the informations through books or internet. So we need to collect the informations by directly. So that's why this is also one of the merit. Third one, these are more reliable. Primary data are more reliable because it is usually objective and collected directly from the original source. That's why it is more reliable and accuracy. And fourth one, it needs no extra precautions. Why the primary data are not require extra precautions? Because here investigator collect the informations directly from the population so that we can get exact result from that person. That's why there is no need to additional precautions. So these are all the merits of primary data. Thus we can say that primary data are original in nature because they are collected by the field workers enumerate investigators for the first time for their own use. Along with primary data are up-to-date information. Here, we can collect up-to-date information directly from the field in real time. Thus, we can say that primary data are very helpful for collecting the exact data. Next, we'll discuss about then what are the demerits or disadvantages of primary data. First one, it requires lot of time. That means it is time consuming. Primary data takes too much of time to collect the information. Why? Because here the investigator, he collects the information directly from the population. And it is a matter of lot of time to conduct the research from the beginning to the end. That means it requires a lot of period of time to collect the each and every informations from the field. So that it requires a lot of time. Second one, it needs much money. That means it is more expensive. Primary data are more expensive or it requires much money. Why? Because primary data, they have to follow the whole study procedure, organizing the materials and process, etc. Because here, an investigator collects the information from the people, that is step by step. That each step requires a lot of expenditure. A proper or better result requires each and every steps so that it should follows whole study procedures as well as the organizing materials. Third one, these data can be obtained through skilled persons only. That means primary data can be collected by only the skilled people, because skilled people, they can easily, accurately collect the information as much as possible. Thus, skilled people very essential for primary data. Fourth one, sometimes these data are not available altogether. That means primary data, sometimes it should not be get a complete picture of information, because the informations can be biased or influenced or some other reasons, so that we cannot expect all the informations regularly from all the people. Thus, we can say that primary data, it is not always possible. The collection of data, it is not always possible. These are all the demerits of primary data. Next, we'll move on. Then, what are the methods of collection of primary data? Which are the methods to collect the primary data? So that we can discuss here one by one. First one, survey. Then, what is survey? How the investigator conduct the surveys? And how this survey helpful to collect the primary data? Survey method is one of the primary sources of data, which is used to collect quantitative information about items in a population. So, through this survey, investigator, he can collect information very accurately, because here he can get a quantitative result or quantitative information. This survey method, which helps to the investigator to perform better in future. Thus, for the collection of data, survey method also helpful to collecting the every information. Next, second method, observation. Then what is observation? How to observe the data? Observation as one of the primary sources of data. Observation is defined as accurate watching and noting of phenomena as they occur in nature with regards to cause and effect relation. That means every information we need to collect because to provide a better solution. By observation method, we can get every information as much as possible so that we can find out the solutions for such problems. Thus, observation method is nothing but which provide accurate watching as well as noting phenomena of nature and which will find the solution for cause and effect relationship. And it also identifies the cause and effect relationship. Compared to questionnaire method, observation method has a big advantage because the observed person doesn't know that he or she is being observed. So the behavior will be natural. In this case, we can lock out the unconscious or conscious lies. And also observation can be used not only in the offline field but in online web stores or any other website we can use. So this is what observation method of collecting the data. Next, third one, interview method. Then what is interview method? Interviewing is a technique that is primarily used to gain an understanding of the underlying reasons and motivations for people's attitudes, preferences or behavior. So such type of method which is most widely used in a primary data collection. And here in this interview method, interviewer ask questions either personally or through mail or telephone from the respondents to obtain the insights of the problem under study. And the researcher may either visit the respondent in person at his home or meet him at the central locations as mutually decided by them. And this interview method, which involves two groups of people, where first group is interviewer as well as he will ask the questions and afterwards he collect the informations. Thus, interview method also played a major role for collecting the data. And last method, that is questionnaire or questionnaire method. Then what is questionnaires or questionnaire method? Here the respondents are given list of written items which he responds to by ticking the one he considers appropriate. So in the questionnaire method, so these are the nature. Here it is the written information. So here respondents are given a list of the written items and he ticking the one. And this considers as a appropriate information. It is the most evident method of data collection, which is comprised of a set of questions related to the research problem. This method is very convenient in case the data are used to be collected from the diverse population. It mainly includes the printed set of questions, either open-ended or closed-ended, which the respondents are required to answer on the basis of their knowledge and experience with the issue concerned. To ask the questions, we can use our own survey, which can be filled in online or in a personal format. Another way to ask questions is through interviewing. So this is what questionnaire. Once again, we revise that methods of collecting the primary data. First one, survey method. Second one, observation method. Third one, interview method. And fourth one is questionnaire method. So these are the methods to collect the primary data. Next, we'll discuss about another one sources of data, that is secondary data, in the next episode. Now, we'll move on exercise questions of this episode. First question, what is primary data? Question number 2, what are the merits of primary data? Question number 3, explain any 2 demerits of primary data. Question number 4, what are the methods of collection of primary data? These are the exercise questions of this episode. Okay, students, we'll meet on next episode again. Thank you.